Maguindanao massacre. Guilty verdict. The Maguindanao massacre was, what, 2009. 58 people murdered. One body never found. Quezon City RTC branch 221 Judge Jocelyn Solis Reyes found 28 guilty to have acted as principal of the crime. 15 accessories to the crime. 53 acquitted on the grounds of reasonable doubt. 3 acquitted as prosecution failed to prove their guilt. All accused were acquitted of the murder case of photojournalist Rinaldo Momay, whose body was never found. Your thoughts?
Ang unang tanong ko dyan, boy, is why it took 10 years?
Why, Professor?
Well, I think partly we have a systemic problem, probably not only in the judiciary, but in the whole political setup.
What is wrong with that system? What is wrong with that political judicial system?
For instance, what evidence do you need in a case of a Maguindanao massacre where the crime was committed in broad daylight and it will take 10 years
Magandang for the, our justice yan, system pupuntahan ko lang ang abogado. Pupuntahan ko po ang abogado. Attorney, I think that's a very valid question. Unang tanong ko, sa ibang bayan, ganun din ho ba? I mean, 10 years, 20 years, 15 years. At bakit?
Doon sa mas mabubuting bayan, hamak na mas mabilis.
Katulad, gaano kabilis ang mabilis?
Well, within 1 year.
Oh.
Okay. But ito kasi, pwedeng i-justify kasi maraming akusado, maraming mga biktima. But ako bilang abogado, tandaan natin, ang huwes nito, walang ginawa sa 10 years, kundi itong kaso na ito lang. But yet, it took her 10 years.
So why? So sabi one Professor reason, Wadi, political, judicial system, what's wrong?
No, one reason also is that our justice system has become too technical. Ang dami ng jurisprudence, ang dami ng mga batas, that kung simple, guilty, not guilty, ang dami ng mga pwedeng gawin eh. At ang dami ng mga technicalities na kinakailang maingat yung huwes. So it takes a lot more time. So we have to simplify the law.
What?
That's
Attorney.
Against our ethics to prolong the case. But
so a lawyer should never?
Should never.
Okay.
But of course, the other duty you have is to defend or prosecute to the best that the law
will allow. But buying time, is that part of that strategy?
That's not part.
No, but realistically, I mean in real talk, Attorney, may mga abogado na magsasabi, patagalin natin ng konti para iba na ang gobernador, iba na ang mayor, iba na ang ganito. Does that happen?
Maari yan. Why would the lawyer think that way? Because he doesn't trust, he doesn't believe in the justice system.
Na pwede pumabalik doon.
O pag nagpalit ng tao, mag-iiba ang desisyon. Which is not rule of law.
Yes, Cleve.
Also, pwede naman din nating parang tignan on another note na kapag binigyan natin ng dedicated na judge, tinutukan natin, matagal pero maaabot natin yung guilty verdict.
Paano natin tututukan ang judge na yon? Is that even part of our responsibility to pay attention to whoever is judging a particular case? Yes, Czarina.
That is what I wanted to add. As a sociologist, my lens on the Maguindanao massacre is different from the system. Yeah. No? Kasi what's very definite about this case is kung paano may komunidad, the dedicated community of journalists, you used memory as a tool to make sure that anyone who is handling and the people who's watching, naaalala nila yung Maguindanao massacre.
And that's what I'm trying to say, na the Maguindanao massacre is being framed as a lesson na ang tagal ng hustisya sa bansang to. Pero yung positive note din doon is that it's also a lesson that when we come together, we can get justice. It's not only nationally significant, it's actually globally significant, di ba?
Of course.
It's the worst recorded crime against journalists in one event. No?
Magandang gabi, Pilipinas. Welcome to The Bottom Line.